Hey everyone, I'm very excited to start this series on Chrome extension development. I'm going to focus on how to build XPath tool. We know that there are plenty of tools out there in the market, but nothing is tagged as an open source, or even if it's open source, there are no tutorials or proper guidance. So in this series, we are going to learn how to build XPath tool. Now, this is going to be a complete open source project, so I'm expecting you guys to do the contribution as well. You can do the contribution by developing XPath patterns, or you can focus on the UI designing, or the most important, you can test the application. Now, the prerequisites are very simple. You have to learn JavaScript. Now, I have a playlist on JavaScript, probably you can watch that. The main concept what you have to learn is string, arrays, function, and maybe regular expression. If you know that, then you are good to start the contribution work project. In this video, we are going to see how to set up our IDE, and also we'll see how to load our extension in Chrome browser using the developer option. So first I'm going to create a project here. So Ctrl J to bring up my terminal, and here I'm going to create a node project. So npm init -y. So -y basically doesn't going to ask you anything about like the project description and name. It is just going to create a default pack project. Okay. So as of now, I'm giving the name to this extension as LetX. Maybe in later on stages we can change that. Okay, so that is pretty much fine. Now we are going to also use this dependency, which is @types chrome, which is nothing relevant to our extension, but whenever we are going to type the code, we need some suggestion, right? So for that I'm going to use this. Okay, so the installation has been done. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create some folders here. So let it be app, and within the app we want the src, and within the src I'm going to create a manifest, but manifest file should be always in the project level. So here I'm going to create a manifest .json, basically a JSON file which holds all the details of your extension, like the name, version, who is the author, what the project is about. So we are going to give some basic details in the manifest.json. I'm going to increase the font a little bit. So if I go to this workspace, and here I can make this as 20. Okay, so manifest, obviously it should start with the curly braces, and here I have to give some basic details like name, description. So I'm going to just copy and paste. So if I go to this website, where this is the official website from Chrome, which is developer.chrome.com/extension. Now here we are going to copy this, and let me paste it here. So here we have this name, which is going to be our LetX, and description. So here I can say open source project. Now it starts with the version 1.0 and manifest version 2. Okay, so this manifest version is the important thing here. So manifest version 2, actually it is expected to release the 3 version, but it is still in the process. So as of now we can stick with the version 2. And then what we need, this file is sufficient to load our extension in the browser. Let me show you that. So here if I go to this Chrome :// extension, here you have to toggle this on, so it will be by default it will be off, so you have to enable this. Then you select this load unpacked and go to the file where you have this. So let's check the file path. Okay, so you have to take the path where you have this manifest.json file. Okay, so copy the entire path and go back to your browser, and here paste it. So here it's going to open. Now here we can see that LetX and it has version 1.0 and we got this ID. Now each and every browser, I mean each and every extension has its own unique ID. Now this icon looks very bad, right? So we are going to give an icon for this. So if I go here and if I go to this overview, here I can say this is the syntax to get the icons. So I'm just going to copy one at a time. So or else let's copy everything and let me add this in our JSON file. So comma and then followed by this icons, right? Yeah. So let me format this. So format. Yeah. Now here we no need to mention this 128 and everything. So it can be like by default, it will take whatever the image file you are going to give, it will compress that to 128. But we can also give specifically the sizes are 16, 32 and 48. So as of now, I'm just going to have one and let me bring my icons here. So I can copy this icons to this folder here and let me create a folder for this so that in that way we can maintain our code. So within the app folder or maybe within this parent folder, I can create asset maybe. Okay, now within the assets folder, I'm going to just bring this here. So let me move this. Okay, that's fine. Now here I can give the path, so which is ASSETS, then slash, then let's rename this to 16 and 32. So 16, and here it's going to be 32. Really very small icon because these icons are going to be placed in this location, so it should be small only. So do not worry about that, Chrome can handle that. So here I'm going to say 32.png. So that is pretty much enough. Now let's go back to the browser and if I go and refresh this, now it says that we have path error. Okay, so could not load extension because of the path error. So I think I have misspelled. Yeah, so let me delete this. And if I go back and retry, now see here we are getting this icon and here also we are getting this icon here at it looks like it's in turned off, right? That's the reason is we didn't say like in which location it should run. Location in the sense which page. For example, if I go to this LinkedIn, it should run here, or if I go to this developer Chrome website, it should run here. So we are going to say that by giving the permission. So if you see here we have this permission, right? So I'm going to copy this permission and here I'm going to paste that. Now I can specify this like maybe different website or active tab, but we want our extension to run in each and every website, right? So for that, what can we do is we can use this wildcard, that is all URL. So within string, I have to say all underscore URLs. So it should be all URL. So let's go back to the extension tab and let me refresh. So here it's, we are getting this error saying that all URL is unknown pattern. So it should be all URLs, I believe. So let's go back and again refresh. Yeah, so it should be all underscore URLs, right? Now if I go to any website, you can see, right, this is, we are getting this green color, right? That means our extension is working perfectly. Now if I go to this tab, it is going to again turn off because we cannot run any of our code within this page. So Chrome colon slash slash extension, here we cannot run anything. Okay, so that's pretty much fine as of now. Then what we can do is let's write something. Okay, so within the src folder, I'm going to create a content script. Okay, so content.js. Now there are few keywords like content script, background and the message passing system. So probably we'll learn that in our further videos. As of now, what I'm going to do is whenever you refresh any page, it should give us some alert saying that will come. Okay, so that is what we are going to do now. So here I'm going to say document dot, just I can write the alert, I think. So alert, and then I can say welcome. In our manifest, .json file, we have to say that where this content file is located. That is, we have to give the path of this. Okay, so let's check the documentation. So here, if I go to this manifest format, I can see that it should be loaded within this content script, right? So I'm going to copy this, and here I'm going to paste. And then here we have to give some array values, right? So within the curly braces, we have to give some value. So now let's again check this content script. And here it says that some runtime, do not worry about this as of now. So it needs active tab, but we have given all URL, so that's pretty much fine. And then here we are saying we have to use this, right? So within this curly braces, we have to give this JS, right? So JavaScript file, whatever the JavaScript file you are going to inject, you have to pass it here. Okay, so within the curly braces, I'm going to say JavaScript file. Let me format this, and here I have to give the file path, right? So here it should be like app, then followed by slash src slash, then content.js. okay, so it's content, it's technical terms, but this is our file name, so that is what we are passing here. Okay, now let me go to my Chrome browser, and again let me refresh this. So if you're not getting a refresh icon here, probably you can refresh this entire page, and then you will get that. Okay, so I think it's turned off, so let me turn on again and try. Okay, so something wrong. Let's remove this and let's add again. So I'm going to give the same path, and I'm going to select the folder. Now it says that content script of zero matches is missing. Okay, so let's fix that. So seems like matches is also mandatory, so I'm going to just copy this, and here I'm going to paste that. And here, instead of this website, I'm going to just give our all URLs. So all underscore URLs, URLs. Okay, so now let me go here and let me retry. Yeah, so we got this. So my bad. So here we have to give the matches and also the JavaScript file. Now if you have some CSS file, probably you can give that as well, but we will do that in later on stages. So if I go back here and if I refresh the page, now as soon as I refresh the page, here you can see that it says welcome, right? So this is actually coming from our extension. Now if I go back to this LinkedIn, and if I go to any other page, then as soon as the browser gets loaded, we will get the extension, right? So if I refresh again, it should give me an alert saying that welcome, right? So this is pretty much enough as of today, because this is our first video. Later on stages, we will learn how to find the XPath using JavaScript, and then we will move to the advanced level. Okay, so I hope you have enjoyed the video, and I will share the entire code base in my Git repository. So there is a repository called LetX. So I will share there. You can grab the source code, and as well as you can fork, and you can send me a pull request as well. So I'm hoping best for this XPath to entire series, and also to do the release of this. Okay, so that's it from my side. See you in the next one very soon. Tada, bye bye, take care.